when we first started working on Valorant, we had our wild hopes and dreams that this would be a shooter that everybody in the world could play.
All right, I'm going in.
Valorant would be something that empowered players' creativity, empowered their expression, and could change how they think about tactical shooters. When I think about how far Val has come as a game over the last 4 years, now feels like the right time to bring Valorant to console players.
With this console version of the game, what we were asking for the team to do was actually just be very curious. What maybe started as some amount of skepticism turned into optimism. And once they had that, then they turned it into a determination that they're going to make something that players truly love.
There are components of Val that exist in other games on console. What Val brings that is maybe different is it's highly tactical combat that has high highs and low lows, allows for a tremendous amount of expression from the player. And we believe that is a combination that players on console are hungry for.
My name's Dre. I go by your boy Dre in game. I've had a pro background for 5 years, and I am a part of the Valorant game analysis team for Riot.
My name's Devin. I go by Demise. I have previous background in Call of Duty as a professional player. I'm also part of the game analysis team at Riot.
We are just a group of passionate gamers who have come together, and we just give a different look and a different form of insight that designers might not have from our experience as like high-level gamers.
Obviously, controllers are very different from mouse and keyboard, so figuring out how to adapt Valorant to still feel like Valorant on console, but through a different control paradigm definitely took a lot of effort and was one of our biggest challenges.
I remember there was one specific moment in development when we knew we had it.
We play a best of three match on controller, and one of the teams won, and then the other team was like, no, we're going again. Like, we're not done. Like, we gotta get back out there. And it was this moment of like, oh, people are taking it way more seriously. They're trying to get better. They wanna compete and they wanna win. To me, that moment of you're not just playing for work, you're playing because the game is really fun is like, oh, we have something. This is what we want players to experience.
Valorant is a very mouse-focused game. It requires a lot of dexterity.
One of the things that we really focused on when we were getting the game to feel really good on controller was to manage the limitations of it. You're trying to move through the environment with your right stick as fast as you can, but you also need to be hyper-precise. Being able to do both of those things with one stick is a very challenging problem.
When we first got our hands on Valorant on console, it was a much different experience than we have right now.
It was a bit clunky. We needed something to make it easier for players to slow down and hone in on gunfights when they need to. I think our switch to what we call a focus mode, that was a big turning point for us.
That was when I kind of had that click. I felt like maybe this could actually work.
It's kind of your button you press before you take a fight. Your sensitivity drops down, you zoom in, you become precise. You should feel like you're about to be accurate when you're trying to hit the really long range shot.
We've come really far, you know, things that seemed very impossible, like turning a flash or like shooting a silver dart, are now pretty easy to do with practice.
What we didn't want console players to feel like they were getting was a watered down version of the game or something that didn't meet the same level of competition and mastery that we were seeing in the PC.
Our gameplay analysis team has extensive backgrounds in both Valorant and console shooters, and that level of nuanced, detailed feedback has enabled us to dial in the game to get it to where it is today.
The designers really did a great job of tweaking every agent individually.
Agents are an incredibly deep part of this game, and everyone brings its own unique set of skills and abilities to the table.
I think you will like this.
A big concern I had coming in was just how little input controller gives us. Coming from PC, you have like possibly hundreds of inputs on a keyboard.
We wanted to make sure that every agent on console felt balanced and considerate of the control scheme.
Our ability mapping for agents feels like very intuitive, and being able to gain that mastery over that specific character has been like really rewarding.
When we talk about competitive games, one of the most important parts of any competitive game is dialing in your settings.
Right now, like, we're all going through the process of just sharing settings and just come up with new ideas on ways to play console.
We're not trying to force any specific presets. We've added on several presets to ensure that all players coming from all sorts of different console games will be comfortable playing our game, whether that's bumper jumper or something very traditional.
You gotta be able to set your settings the way you want them. And we've made sure that players get to customize their controls however they want.
We believe we have built the right infrastructure, the right tooling to really make the promise of the game shine. Valorant is one ecosystem. It doesn't matter what platform you're on, it's one community. We didn't want you to have to go create a new account or to worry about where should I go to progress my battle pass. To us, a part of that is making sure that whenever you log into Valorant, it's your Valorant. We made the very conscious choice of not having cross-play between PC and consoles because we don't want players to have to wonder, is the person I'm playing against using a controller or a keyboard and mouse or whatever else?
When I watch players experience the love of Valorant in that truly pure way, and it doesn't matter what hardware they're on, that's how we know we've got it. That's what gives us the courage to launch Valorant to console.
I think the thing that makes Valorant really unique is just the global community as a whole.
Between the game and the esport and the cosplay and the music and the music videos and the incredible passion players show in and out of the game.
When console players come into the community, they get to experience that same thrill and that same level of play.
We are so dependent on console players joining the beta and telling us where are we doing it right, where are we not doing it right. We're excited to engage directly with players so that they can help us grow and make this game amazing for everyone. We'll be right back.